our professional studies director, Dr. Vigitovsky, present here. There's some exciting news like last year that he will be telling you. Before that, I give the hand of the mic to Mr. Uberoi, President of the Alumni Association.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Vijayasani, for coming here. Thank you, the members of the press. Very good afternoon. Namaskaram to one of you. Like Father said, I am the first batch of Christ University in 1960. Okay. To celebrate that big event, we members thought that let us felicitate Christites serving from the Indian Armed Forces, whether it's the Army, Navy, and uniforms or in their peps, and including till some two ladies also coming. One, I think she's from the Navy and the other is from the Air Force. You have a list in front of you of about 24 or 25 alumni who are coming on 26th. We'll be honoring each of them separately. And that is the data, the year of passing, and the ranks are there. Of course, during this time, we have from our data that we have lost three alumni during various conflicts, Kargil, the Kashmir thing. One of them martyred is Major Sylvester, who's from Bangalore. His mother will be attending the program and will be especially recognizing his effort. There's a second alumni, also Captain Pradeep, who also was got martyred during the Kashmir trouble. We're trying to get his parents there from Kannur. Hopefully we should be able to tie that up. And the third alumni, of course, who passed away was during, of course, illness, but not during a war or any campaign. So these are the alumni who are coming. They'll be honored that day. They're coming in uniform. It's going to be a privilege for Father, myself, and everybody who are present there to recognize people who are the true watchmen of this country. While we sleep, they stand guard. So it's an opportunity for us to salute them, to recognize their effort, and to tell the world that even Christites from 1969 have been serving in the various armed forces. A small bit on the Alumni Association. We're a pretty active group over here, and we have about 35 to 38,000 who are registered. So about 60,000 alumni all over the world. Our activities are based quite a bit. Scholarship is one of the biggest activities which I take. There's various other activities for the faculty. This last year, our financial year, what we just closed in October, we raised and spent 34 lakhs rupees in the campus, of which the maximum amount, about 70 to 80 lakhs, went to scholarship of needy Christites. The balance went for gold medals, various other events we do.
The universities. So the 11th was with Bangalore University at that point of time, which was also newly started in Bangalore, bifurcation from Mysore University. And so the first batch of Christ College, in some sense, was the pre-degree batch of the Alumni Association, which passed out, became alumni in 1917, of course. Mr. Jugnu, Uberoi is from the first batch, which joined in 1969 and graduated in 1970 from the 11th standard. But of course, he continued for his undergrad as well here thereafter. So we are celebrating the 50th anniversary, 50th celebration of our contribution to the society, in the sense that universities don't produce students for themselves. They make them better, they enhance their abilities, they make them more useful citizens to the society. So it's also the 50th anniversary of our contribution. And of course, we have produced students who have served in many capacities, in members of the parliament, members of legislative assemblies, military personnel, IAS officers, you can name the field, they all have been there. Including the some of the foreign countries' ministers have also have come from this country, such as we have from Bhutan, we have, as I said, they all are coming flying down from their respective unit just for these 2 days, taking leave from their respective units, and they're going back to the unit soon after the event. So we appreciate their kind of effort they are putting in to be with us on those 2 days. In fact, maybe here on 25th. They will be going to the addressing all the students in all our three campuses in Bangalore. So they will address students here, interact with them, motivate them about the armed forces, about the some of the values and life they need to uphold. They also go to the Manavata and the Kengeri campuses as well and talk to the students there. So apart from the 26 being present, which is at 11:15 program.
ಇದು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಹೇಳಿ ಸರ್.
1969ರಲ್ಲಿ ಶುರುವಾದ ಈ ಸಂಸ್ಥೆಯ ಸುವರ್ಣ ಸಂಭ್ರಮ ಕಳೆದ ವರ್ಷ ನಾವು ಆಚರಿಸಿದ್ದೆವು. 1969ರ ಬ್ಯಾಚ್ 1970ರಲ್ಲಿ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಜುಯೇಟ್ ಆಯಿತು, ಪಾಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಹಾಗೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಈ ವರ್ಷ ನಾವು ನಮ್ಮ ಹಳೆ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿ ಸಂಘದ ಸುವರ್ಣ ಸಂಭ್ರಮ ಆಚರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ. 50 ವರ್ಷಗಳ ಸೇವೆಯನ್ನು ಆಚರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ. ಈ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಹಲವಾರು ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ದೇಶಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇರೆ ದೇಶಗಳಿಗೆ ಹಳೆ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ಸೇವೆ ಸಲ್ಲಿಸಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಆದರೆ ಈ ವರ್ಷ ನಾವೇನು ಏನಿಸ್ತೇವೆ ಅಂದರೆ, ಭಾರತೀಯ ಸೇನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಹಲವಾರು ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳು ಸೇವೆ ನೀಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ನೀಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವರನ್ನು ನಾವು ಕರೆದು ಅವರನ್ನು ಗೌರವಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ. ಒಟ್ಟು 21 ನಮ್ಮ ಹಳೆ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳು, ಹುಡುಗರು ಮತ್ತು ಹುಡುಗಿಯರು ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಭಾರತೀಯ ವಾಯುಸೇನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ, ನೌಕಾಸೇನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಗೂ ಭೂಸೇನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸೇವೆ ನಡೆಸ್ತಾರೆ. ಅವರನ್ನು ಕರೆದು ಅವರನ್ನು ನಾಡಿದ್ದು ಜನವರಿ 26ರಂದು ನಮ್ಮ ಹಳೆ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿ ಸಂಘದ ಸಂಭ್ರಮದ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರನ್ನು ಗೌರವಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಹಾಗೆಯೇ ನಮ್ಮ 3 ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳು, ಇಬ್ಬರು ಕಾರ್ಗಿಲ್ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ ತಮ್ಮ ಹುತಾತ್ಮರಾಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅವರ ಮನೆಯವರನ್ನು ಕರೆದು ಅವರನ್ನು ನಾವು ಗೌರವಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ. ಈ ರೀತಿ ನಮ್ಮ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳಲ್ಲಿ, ನಮ್ಮ ಸಂಸ್ಥೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಸೇನೆಯ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಗೌರವ ಬೆಳೆಯಲಿ, ಹಾಗೆ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಮಂದಿಗೆ ಸೇನೆಯನ್ನು ಸೇರಲು ಅವಕಾಶ ಸಿಗಲಿ ಎಂದು ನಾವು.
ಎಷ್ಟು ಜನಕ್ಕೆ ಫೆಲಿಸಿಟೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಸರ್ ಆ ದಿನ? ಎಷ್ಟು ಜನಕ್ಕೆ ಸನ್ಮಾನ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ?
21 ಮಂದಿ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅವರನ್ನು ನಾವು ಸನ್ಮಾನ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ.
ಓಕೆ ಸರ್, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹೆಸರು ಹೇಳಿ ಬಿಡಿ.
ನಾನು ಅನಿಲ್ ಜೋಸೆಫ್ ಬಿಂಟು, ಕ್ರೈಸ್ಟ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ.
They come, they want their children also to come here. Yesterday, one of my own student visited me. Father, I want my son's admission next year in Christ. That means they are all proud of their alma mater, Christ University. And that's why they are coming, especially my own students. Because I told them. Then, every year, because of the alumni president, he could gather more than 2,000 students, alumni students, every year. It's a huge gathering. And it's a very, very nice experience for us. This much students come and greet the teachers. So we can recognize their faces, not the names, but we can recollect which batch they went out. And they're also very happy. That's very, 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 very good news for me. The Christites are always happy. They're always telling me, Mother, we are trained in Christ, we will not fail in our life. We know how to overcome the situations, the crisis in our life. So that is the attitude of our, positive attitude about students. So I can listen to from them directly and also feel the happiness and contentment.
They are felicitating 21 students on that day.
21, that alumni, they're the armed forces. There may be Navy or Air Force or the Army.
Who have come up from this college.
Yeah. We are proud of them. We are proud of them. Because my own students, I remember after NCC, one alumni day, 3 years before one alumni day, 26, they came from training from Allahabad, 1 year serious training from Allahabad. Father, I graduated for the Army. So that is it. So students are very much enthusiastic about joining Army and they are serving well, which is our responsibility to recognize them.
In future, I think most students like to get into this field.
Yes, NCC. Sajina, what is the last point? NCC is a tough selection process. She is the Lieutenant Sajina, okay? She is in charge of NCC.
The number is increasing.
Number is increasing every year. And I can see every Saturday, the march fast, the discipline, everything is wonderful. And also we had a camp for 600 students from all over Karnataka and Goa in our other campus, Kengeri campus. This is a 10-day program.
This year, Kengeri camp?
Yeah.
Last four years
it is happening.
Last three years.
How many students have participated in that camp?
We have more representation towards the national camps like RDC, DSC.
Yes.
RDC, how many are going?
RDC, five of them.
Five students are going for RDC.
Yes, they are already there. Talsenic 6, para-jam, shooting representation. Number of representation of
West. And also good shooters. I watched, I observed them one day, okay? Our shooters are sharp shooters in the firing range in the Kangiri campus.
Two of them represent.
Yeah. They represent in India?
India.
Yeah.
Okay, sir. Thank you,
sir. Held in Singapore.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. For the training. For 1 week or 2 weeks?
10 days.
It's a special selection. And the management is sponsoring Lieutenant Sajina, Lieutenant Dinesh, and Father Biju. They're going for the...
South Korea.
This is only...
Officers of
training.
It's a training for a tie-up with the Christ University for youth exchange program.
Youth exchange program. Yes, sir. Start.
Namaskara. My name is Jugnu Uberoi. I am the Christ University Alumni President from the first batch of Christ College 1969. This year, we celebrate our 50 years Alumni Association growth. And to honor that, it's a very big event on 26th January, where around 1,500 to 2,000 alumni from all over India come in. We're going to honor our alumni who are in the armed forces, Army, Navy and Air Force. Around 25 of them coming from all over India in their uniforms, including we're going to honor two of our alumni who were martyred in Kargil and the Kashmir conflict. So the parents are coming, we'll be honoring them that day in the morning at 11 o'clock onwards. The program is there. So it's an honor for us to respect these alumni who are serving the nation and serving the country.
When is the program held, sir?
It's held at the Christ University campus on 26 January at the Auditorium block, followed by lunch, of course. It's an invitation to every Christite to please be there and to salute these men in uniform. And these men, there are two ladies also coming who are from the Air Force and Navy in their uniforms also, who are Christites. Thank you.
Can you stand up for the photographs?